In my last episode, we started the program for this, and we left it half complete. So, let's finish it up. Picking up where we left off, we have this mechanism for the pin sweep. So now, let's rebuild that into the actual pin sweep. With some slight modifications, now it's done. It has to be a little shorter, as the pin setter is only so tall. It's just taller than a pin, and that's the same height there. So, let's test it. Adding those two beams now makes the chain have much more tension. So, if I hold this gear, now it'll lift itself up. There we go. Like every other time, installing the pin sweep did not go too smoothly. First, I ran out of gear racks, so I had to place an order to receive more of those. Then, I went to the LEGO store and bought more tiles, but eventually, I got it working for the initial test. So, I got this entire side basically done. So now, if I hold this side up, just to where it's not sagging much, we can see that it can go up, and then back down, and then go back, and forth, and then up. So, now it's just time to do that side. Both sides of the pin sweep have the same mechanism, where they have the gear, and then a red guiding gear, and then they have a dark gray knob that keeps it down, so when the pins push kind of back towards it, it's locked in place. Until it goes forwards, it's now no longer underneath the plates and can go up. With both sides now in, let's give it a test. So right now it's up, and then it can go down and backwards. And while I wanted to show the pin sweep be able to push that ball back, I didn't have the gear racks until they came in the mail. As well as the gear racks, I ordered a whole lot more bricks, so that way we can fill the inside with all the supports necessary. So, now that we have the gear racks that I can install into the machine, I ran into another issue. While testing it with the gear racks all in place, I realized that the motor spins a lot slower than what it should. Turns out, it was still under quite a bit of stress. So, by swapping out the gears to have a better ratio to make it easier for that motor, it's able to push much easier. With all of those issues fixed, it was now time to move on to the next program. Instead of having a complex system that would have the communication between the program that has all the treads underneath and the program that sets the pins where they need to go, I decided to move the program for the motor that drives that big chain to the one that actually needs those pins. So, let's test that. By eliminating all the useless communication system in that program, it makes it much faster. Unfortunately, the pins are no longer lining up with where they need to go. So, I tweaked that, so now they work perfectly fine. So I got the couple of fixes we needed for that pin distributor done, so now let's program the pin sweep. So I tested the pin sweep over and over again, being able to push pins and the ball, and it actually worked pretty well. As well as testing the pin sweep, I also tested how well it can get the ball from the one side of the track to the other and down the chute. And it actually works really, really well. Instead of having a sensor that detects when the carriage moves up and down, I swapped it out for this sensor that's able to detect once the pin sweep goes back and then once it goes forward. So now, with a little bit of programming and some testing, I finally have all the calculations done for how far that motor needs to spin. As we can see through this gap, the yellow piece went under that sensor. And then, once I press this again, it'll come back. And now, let's get the whole system running. While I finish the rest of the program, I want to encourage you guys to make sure you subscribe. It's always free. And that way, you never miss a video. It'll give you the notifications right when I upload. With all the programs done, let's give it the first test. I have no idea how this is gonna go, but let's give it a shot. So, it'll first begin by sweeping the playing field. While everything seemed to be working, that pin didn't actually go where it needed to go. So let's begin fixing that. We need to get the pins to be able to line up perfectly with the carriage, as well as have the pins be able to slide through the carriage. I realized that one of the issues were the pins themselves. They're made of cones that I bought used instead of new ones. So the used ones may be bent slightly to where that 4-stud diameter is not perfect in some places. So I reordered new ones so that way they are perfect. Now that the pins are able to go through the carriage smoothly, I worked on the racking system to make sure that was working well. Next, I took out the carriage and added another layer of bricks as well as these curved pieces. That way, the gap between the rack and the carriage was much smaller, and if it was offset a bit, they would slide in. While we have the carriage out, let's upgrade the drive, because right now, it has the 3 points, but they're connected by things like universal joints in multiple places, and it makes this side lag behind quite a bit. Switching out those universal joints for gears allows it to mesh much better, and now that side does not lag behind. With a quick test, now all three of them can go up and down at the same height. So, I then put the carriage back in the machine, and we're ready to fix the pin sweep, as I saw an issue while I was testing. So if the carriage has picked up any of the pins, the motor of the pin sweep runs into that pin, so I need to drop that motor down. With the pin sweep redone, as well as the carriage, I now have all the pins up top in besides that final pin. So when I put this pin in, it should be able to drop them and set them down. So I just deposited that pin, and now the pin sweep is going to go back and clear the lane, and then it'll come back forth. Now it'll drop the pins into the carriage, and then the carriage will go down and release the pins. I sped this clip up a bit, just so that way we could get to the point where the pin does not actually go through the carriage. I had to kind of help it there, so let's fix that. So the program now agitates the pins a little bit so they'd fall down. As well as adjusting the program, I added these bricks that act as an alignment corner when the carriage is pressed against it. Let's add this 10th pin and see it in action. As you saw that time, instead of just lifting up and then going back down, it lifted the pins up so they could fall down and then went back and then back up. So that way it kind of shakes the pins in case any of them get stuck. Once that carriage went all the way down, it then dropped all the pins and goes back up. Once all the way up, the pin sweep will then lift up, allowing you to bowl. So if I roll the ball here to where it knocks over some pins but not all of them, we'll now be able to see that it can lift up the pins. Pressing this button will tell it that I bowled. Now it'll go down, pick up the pins, then run the pin sweep, and then go back down, set them down, and then lift up the pin sweep. This process takes quite a bit of time, and it's something I want to speed up, but for now I just sped up the video by 2 times, so it's a little quicker for you guys. Once the carriage reaches the top, that pin sweep lifts up, and now we can bowl again. After pressing the button up top to tell it that we bowled that second time, the pin sweep runs, and then it'll just wait for all 10 pins up top, and then it would drop them down and begin another round. With all the programs now done, this whole front is finalized, so now we can move on to the lane in the next episode. So be sure to subscribe, as it's always free, and it's the best way to show that you guys watch my videos. And I'll see you guys in the next episode.